But then he cried over an avocado and not eating an avocado. And I was like, I'm so sorry. This is a no from me. Hi, we're the cast of Fate the Winx Saga.
And we're going to be playing a game of...
Who's most likely to?
Who's most likely to steal something from Seth?
Hannah.
That is so true. That is so true.
I'm going to say baby Hannah. Because she did go, like, we did go back to, like, odd things that we could, that were being sold. Do you remember?
From the costume.
Or like from the costume department. We went back at the end to try and get stuff. And obviously Hannah loves a bargain, so she was on it.
For hours, yeah.
She was on it.
Are you going to say me?
I wasn't thinking that. I don't know what gave you that impression.
Fine. Maybe. No, I wouldn't. I'm not a stealer. I can be sneaky though. I like a little bit of mischief.
I used to steal all the underwear from, like, when they give you like the really ugly like nude color underwear, I'd be like, this is really handy. And also I'm wearing it, so I took it.
Well, fingers crossed we get a series two, and then I'll bring a sack
everything
on the last day.
I wanted my sword. I said to the smithy, I said, can I have this after I'm done? And he went, we'll see. And so on the final day, I went, that's a wrap on Danny. Big, you know, clapping or whatever. And I went, sword? Anyway, no? Okay, cool. All right. Yeah.
Who's most likely to ignore the group chat? Abby.
It's you.
It's me.
She's got time difference though, so.
She has.
We forgive her.
Let her off.
Abby is the most likely, and that is actually true. She is the most likely to ignore the group chat because
she doesn't respond for hours.
But I would never ignore a FaceTime call or a phone call. I don't do that.
Elliot, probably. Yeah. Maybe you as well, Elise. You're pretty good on a group chat.
I think Alicia's quite good at group chat.
Alicia's really good, and I think Hannah is. It's their Virgo energy.
It is. They're the organised ones. So anytime that we, in the days when we were allowed to meet up, it was always very much led by them. And me and Pressure rock up at the last minute.
No, I often just put a load of emojis. That's it, yeah. I'm aware of the group chat and I'll comment, but it would be an emoji.
Who's most likely to binge watch a show in a day?
Oh.
Precious.
Definitely Precious.
Me.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's the biggest binge watcher.
Precious and Alicia, they would watch stuff all the time.
Yeah, like, they would.
They're big TV movie buffs.
Absolutely.
She knows every show ever. It's amazing. I don't know how she retains that much information or has the time. Maybe she's a vampire and doesn't sleep. I don't know.
I've been watching loads of Call My Agent on Netflix, like a French sitcom, and it's so funny. And Bridgerton, obviously. Who hasn't watched Bridgerton?
Honestly, I've been watching Bridgerton and I finished it. And Snowpiercer, which is the new episode, has come out yesterday. So I'll be on that. Yeah.
Potentially, yeah. I like the sound of that.
I think so.
Yeah. He's although brilliant. Imagine if I was like, no, I don't like the guy.
Queen's Gambit was my numero one. Loved it. I really enjoyed Big Mouth. The latest season, I just thought it was so brilliant. Like what it spoke about, it was exactly what we all need to be having conversations about. And it was just, it was brilliant.
I just finished watching about a month ago Stranger Things, hands down, like one of the best TV series I've ever seen in my life. And like, I'm a huge fan of the 80s as well, and sort of that, how you dress as well. And that's just by the by. But also the music in the show is just incredible. The acting is stellar. Pardon the pun.
Big Little Lies. I watched that. Love that. But Schitt's Creek, big fan of Schitt's Creek, love Schitt's Creek. I have a hard time sitting.
Who's most likely to be taking a nap on set?
You, Precious. For sure. Although I'm quite good at napping as well. I can sleep anywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah. Probably both of us.
Abby?
Yeah.
Abby's a great napper, actually.
Yeah.
Impressive. It's pretty impeccable.
I mean, it is you, isn't it? I've got like evidence of you like in a chair or like on a sofa, just like literally in between scenes. Just...
If she was in this interview, she might be able to get a nap in during.
I've mastered the art of
of taking little cat naps between setups.
I think there's footage of me napping away somewhere.
Well, I have a picture of Hannah curled up on the floor during the assembly scene.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Yeah. So maybe we're all just really
tired.
Yeah.
Who's most likely to pull pranks on set? I'm going to say either Precious or Abby. Actually, yeah, that is on point. I feel like Precious would do it almost accidentally, and Abby would try and do it, and then it would go tits up.
Abby loves games on set, and it's a really great thing if you have a person you can do it with who is also good at said game. If you have an idiot, that's me, especially these, can't do these.
We had a joke about this. Actually, because we were like, someone's definitely going to ask us who the prankster of the set is. And we were like, we're all going to say it's Precious for no reason. But now you're here, so I can't do it.
Who's most likely to be the biggest fangirl?
Thank you. Hello.
Precious.
But I don't think she would like actively fangirl. I think that she is so like, again, such a big TV movie buff that like, I feel like if she did meet someone that she really admired as an actor, she probably would know like a bunch about them.
I feel like who would be really good at being a fangirl is Hannah, because I feel like if she saw someone who she really liked, she's so charming. I feel like she would befriend them instantly. So she'd manage to fangirl, but like, get the line right between being a fan but like not being overwhelming.
I just get overexcited about everything though.
Hannah is the biggest fangirl ever.
Yeah.
It's amazing. She'll be your hype girl whenever you need it.
I'll be 100%. I think if I see someone that I admire, even if someone just does something well, I'm like, oh, wow, I understand it. So yeah. If I saw Beyonce, I'd probably just melt into a puddle, you know? I fangirled hard over Kate Fleetwood. Like, I got told off because I kept smiling too much in the takes where I was meant to look like scared and uneasy, because I just grew up on her Lady Macbeth with Patrick Stewart, and so it was not easy.
This is really embarrassing. I really fangirled over Noah Centineo in To All the Boys I Loved Before, but then he cried over an avocado and not eating an avocado. And I was like, I'm so sorry, this is a no from me.
Okay, who's most likely to break laughing during a scene?
It's hard to say, because I feel like we all are so guilty of corpsing.
Maybe it's Hannah. I feel like maybe between me and Hannah or Elisha.
There was that scene with Mr. Harvey.
Stop, that was
and
awful.
We kept getting told off because we were crying with laughter, and obviously we're meant to be like really upset that he's got us in this room. But I think we're all
guilty.
Guilty of sin for that one.
Thanks for watching us play Who's Most Likely To.
Make sure to check out Fate, the Winx Saga on Netflix next.